But I also loved Jason's movies, so I felt incredibly fortunate. And then he came over to my house and he said, you know, that pie scene really matters to this film, and mm-hmm. I want to see you make a pie and learn how to make a pie. And he did.
That was really, because I'm horrendous in the kitchen.
And that was really important. When Jason Bartlett came to your house and said, you know what, that seems important in the movie.
I knew my story was in the right hands. And then he flew me to the set on day one to teach Josh Brolin how to make pie.
Oh, wow.
Twisted my arm, you know.
Yeah.
Rough job, but somebody's got to do it. My mother was a great pie maker, Christine. Mm-hmm. And when my mother was dying, her friends would say to me, we're going to miss her, but we're going to miss her pie. Would you give us the recipe? And any baker out there, and I'm sure there are many in the Midwest, in St. Louis, knows it's not about the recipe. The recipe is usually the same.
Sure.
It's how you handle the dough. So I'm going to show you.
Okay, great.
This is exactly how I taught Josh Brolin, who incidentally turned out to be a great pie maker.
Okay.
And it is the sexiest pie scene ever in the history of film, maybe the sexiest baking scene ever. Okay, I've had to, because of time being limited, I rolled out the first crust.
Okay.
And I'm going to tell you, there's a controversy about crust, you probably know. Some people like Crisco, flaky.
Some people
butter,
like butter.
Flavor.
Some like both.
I use both.
Mm-hmm.
Last night in St. Louis, somebody told me about making one with mazola oil.
That was news. Never heard of that.
Okay, how do we get this to here? I already kind of gave it away.
Okay. Now, I know that this is a really important line in the movie as well, which was, I'm sure the director loved having it once that line came out of his mouth.
Well, that's for
about
the top
having
crust.
Commitment and
that's
confidence.
For the top crust. Yeah, you've got to be confident.
When you flip it.
And
yeah.
You don't worry over it, which is perfect for me because I'm kind of a casual joie de vivre type, and I make a mess. This is pretty messy. And you know, I wanted this pie to look like a real person had made it, not
sure.
Martha Stewart.
Right.
I guess she's a real person. But I wanted this to look like a pie that a convict on the run had made. And that's kind of what my pies look like. So that was good. So it looks kind of as it should, flaky.
Yeah.
This is my grandmother's secret ingredient, minute tapioca. Here in St. Louis, this will make sense when I say, sprinkle as much as you would put salt on a winter road if it's very icy.
Familiar with that.
Here's my apples with cinnamon. Less sugar than many people use.
Smells
because
good.
I like the sweetness to come in the form of the ice cream. Okay, now we're going to make the top crust. And I'm going to go fast on this one.
Okay.
Not just because we're on TV, but because you do not linger over it. You don't over the handle the dough. I don't care if Josh Brolin or George Clooney is on the phone. I tell them to wait at this point. Here's what my mixture looks like. Here's the crucial tool, my grandmother's pastry blender.
Okay.
And that's that little meal that I've got. Cuisinart does not
make a flaky.
I hope
we have enough time to get this one right.
Okay,
out.
Here we go.
All right.
Pour in my water.
How much
whirl,
does the
whirl,
temperature
whirl.
Make
a
it?
Lot. Okay. The butter should be cold and the water should be cold. Whirl it up. I don't knead the dough. I make it just barely hold together in a ball.
How many pies do you think you've made in your life?
I have made, you know, I couldn't count, but I'm sure it's over 1,000. Well over 1,000 probably. And I've taught probably 1,000 and some people how to make pie in the 25 years.
And your son's baked.
So you can see my sons have baked their ways into
many a girl's heart.
Well, and now just one is enough for each of them, I'm happy to say, which I know will break the heart of fans of Heart of Dixie. Okay, here's my ball. I roll fast. I'm very happy with how this looks. That is future flakiness.
You're happy why? Because why?
Because it's lifting up a little bit, Christine.
Okay.
And that means it's going to be really flaky. Here's Ida. Just fling a little more. Looks kind of like the state of Indiana. It's not a nice round circle. That's okay. All everything is okay, basically. It's a very forgiving thing, a pie. Some people make their crust too thick. I like a nice thin
to
crust.
Look a little bit like Florida.
Heel of the hand, your absolute best tool.
And
it's
we have about
right
a minute
on your
left.
Own body.
Oh,
a minute. I could make another whole pie.
Okay.
Okay. Here we go. How to get this on this. This was a
all
big
right.
moment in the Labor Day movie. Kate Winslet is a nervous woman. Her hands shake. She gets to this point and she says to Josh Brolin, you do it. But do either of us believe in letting the man do it?
No. And the son, he knows that his mother's hands tremble,
he
right?
does. But he at this particular point, she commits. She does this brave thing. And
confidence
so am
and
I.
Commitment.
Unless you want to do it.
No, I want you to do it.
Flip. Here. Go perfect. Around. Press it down.
And
lift it up.
And
it still looks funky, and that is fine because it's going to taste so great. Go around. little patching. Never hurt anybody.
We're going to put this recipe on our website.
And there'll be a link to my pie making video.
Perfect.
So you can get exactly the lesson that Josh Brolin got, but from me on Curious.com. And in the book, if you read the book Labor Day, on page 64, are very complete instructions.
Okay.
From the mouth of the convict, Frank, but it's really me.
Okay.
Now, this pie, I'm just going to brush my egg on top.
So cute. I love it.
Sprinkle sugar. In Labor Day, he always puts the letter A on for Adele.
Okay.
Because that's the Kate Winslet character's name.
Well, we are going to come back with some final thoughts as she puts the final touches on the pie.
We'll do the best pie.